Today, I'll be discussing design concepts for thermal management of our digital micromirror devices, or DMDs. This topic will cover all DMDs currently offered by DLP products that have a thermal interface area available for heat sinking. All information presented in this video can be found in DMD datasheets accessible on TI.com, with the exception of the last three slides. These will go into examples of application-specific thermal designs. First, we are going to discuss where to get started and where this information is located. We will then take a detailed look into how the heat load for a DMD is calculated, with a sample calculation for a typical projection system included. I will discuss the test point locations on various DMDs and the thermal resistance of a device, followed by a sample calculation of a DMD array temperature. Next, we will get into more details of how to design a DMD heatsink and understand the considerations and assumptions required for each design. Finally, we will end the presentation with tips and best practices on how a heatsink can be optimized. To get started, we want to first download a DMD datasheet that meets your specific application. Access the website ti.com/DLP. On the left product tree, you can go through the different types of products to select the one that is right for you. I will be selecting the DLP 4710, which is a 0.47 1080p DMD in the Pico product family. This information will apply to any other DMD where heat sinking is available. Once you have downloaded the datasheet, scroll to the table of contents. There are three different sections this video will highlight. Before we begin, I want to highlight all the parameters needed for the calculation of the DMD heat load and array temperature. The thermal resistance network on the left shows all the parameters in a typical thermal management system. The illustration on the right shows how the total heat load of the DMD is calculated. Both illustrations will be further discussed in the following slides. All parameters in the middle table are necessary for the calculation, with location defined each in the right column. The first section of the datasheet we will be looking at is the recommended operating conditions section. This section lists the maximum and minimum operating temperatures of the DMD array. For this specific example, the DLP 4710 device has operating temperature range shown in this slide. This information can be found in section 6.4 of the datasheet, titled Recommended Operating Conditions. The array temperature is the variable we are trying to determine to ensure the maximum temperature of the device is not exceeding recommended operating temperatures. The following slides will go through step by step to calculate the array temperature. Please note that the following calculations cover uniform illumination of the DMD only. We will first calculate the array power on the DMD, or total heat load, using these equations. The array power is defined as the sum of the electrical power dissipation and absorbed optical power on the device. For each DMD, the electrical power dissipation is known. We will be using the screen lumens to determine the absorbed optical power by using a conversion factor. The illustration shows the relationship between each parameter discussed. An example calculation using the DLP 4710 device is presented on the bottom section of the slide. Using our assumption of 1500 measured screen lumens, we can calculate the absorbed optical power on the device to be 3.99 watts. Adding the 0.25 watts of nominal electrical power dissipation gives us 4.24 watts of total power on the DMD, which is the total heat load on the DMD. The equation and sample calculation presented on the previous slide is located in section 7.6 on the datasheet, titled Micromirror Array Temperature Calculation. Thermal resistance for each DMD is defined from the active array to the back of the ceramic package. This point on the back of the ceramic is referred to as test point 1, and for this particular DMD, the coordinates are shown here. All DMDs with a thermal interface have a specified location for test point 1, with a defined location within the associated datasheet. The thermal resistance of the DMD is needed to calculate the array temperature of the device. The next step will be a thermal simulation of the DMD and heatsink to monitor the temperature at test point 1, which is the ceramic temperature. For a starting point on the sizing of a heatsink, access the system mounting concept for the device planned to be used on TI.com. This is a step file that can be downloaded of the assembly you see on the screen. The heatsink provided may be a good starting point for the thermal simulation. As previously mentioned, the thermal network diagram shows how heat is transferred from the DMD array to the ambient environment. The assembly also provides a starting point for properly mounting the DMD to ensure it meets system mounting interface loads in the datasheet. Once an initial thermal simulation is set up and ran, temperature at test point 1 can be determined. Using these equations, we can calculate the array temperature. For this example calculation, we plug in our three known variables. First, the measurement at test point 1, or ceramic temperature. Second, total power or heat load of the device. Finally, the thermal resistance from the array to test point 1, which is found in the datasheet. With a DLP 4710 device, a temperature of 55 degrees C at test point 1 and a screen lumens output of 1500 lumens equates to an array temperature of 59.66 degrees C. So in this case, the heatsink provides adequate thermal management. However, additional work is needed to fully optimize the DMD heatsink. The thermal resistance of the DMD can be found in section 6.5 of the datasheet, titled Thermal Information. The equations to calculate the array temperature can be found in section 7.6, titled Micromirror Array Temperature Calculation. Each DMD device will have a different thermal interface area that is detailed in the associated datasheet. The thermal interface area is determined by the size of the opening of the interface on the DMD electronics board. This is important to understand to properly size the DMD heatsink stud, which interfaces to the DMD. The length of the stud is also critical so that the heatsink itself does not interfere with the PCBs the DMD attaches to. More information will need to be understood about the system to optimize this dimension. Other key aspects of designing a DMD heatsink are to have the correct assumptions about your system. This will be important in how a thermal simulation is set up as well. Going down the list on the slide, each one of the parameters needs to be considered with the advantages and disadvantages weighed. Each assumption should be fully evaluated as each can play a role in the performance of the design. Once the simulation and model have been set up, a more refined heatsink can be designed by use of optimization. By varying certain parameters, such as fin thickness or spacing, an optimized heatsink can be obtained to provide the required thermal management needed while limiting the size as well as cost. Several other parameters can also be refined further, such as the use of a fan, type of materials, or other designs that go beyond simple extruded heatsinks. Many assumptions and design features play a role in the thermal management of DMDs. If further help is needed to provide a thermal solution to your application, please contact us at ti.com/DLP. Thank you for your attention and have a great day.